Welcome to JSC's Flying, and today I'd like to give you some tips how to update your macOS on unsupported devices or how to simply update the OpenCore bootloader if you use it. This tutorial will be split in half. First half is I created a bootable USB drive with a patched macOS Big Sur 11.2.3. Which is, by the way, the last stable version for the Mac Pro 5.1, at least if you use NVMe drives. I will soon release another video about a possible fix for that issue that's called Late Bloom. So if you haven't already subscribed my channel, I would suggest you do it and click the bell so you get the notification when I release that video. The second half of my tutorial will be how to update OpenCore. So let's start with the patched USB drive. How to do that, you find in my tutorial that I linked in the description. And by the way, you need a Mac compatible graphics card for that you can see the boot selector. So to reach this boot selector, just keep Option pressed during boot, and about like after 30 seconds, this screen should show up. And I just choose Install macOS Big Sur, that's a USB drive, and then the installer should load and come up. So here we are in the installer, and I just choose macOS Big Sur. Okay, continue. Accept the software license. And now install macOS Big Sur is a USB drive. I cannot select this, obviously, because I cannot install it right now onto the install USB drive. But here you see my hard disk, it's called Big Sur. And I just choose this as a target, say continue. And it takes about 20 minutes. Then there should be a restart. Then another 20 minutes. And then macOS should be updated to 11.2.3. And then we are at the login screen. And here we are with the Apple ID sign in. And you see it's not the regular setup like if you would have set up a brand new macOS, because it's just an update. And as you can see, all my programs are still here in my start menu. And if we check about this Mac, you see it's 11.2.3. updated, and all your data is still there, and you just performed the update. Okay, I just replaced the old Mac graphics card again against my PC graphics card, the RX 580, and you can see here it's macOS Big Sur 11.2.3. If you just click on the version number, by the way, you can get the internal version, the Apple version number. And there you could differentiate if you have 11.2.3 with a security update. If there are more security updates, they just stay on the same version number, but they will change the version code. So here, if you just click on it, you find the version code. Second part is how to update the OpenCore bootloader if you're macOS is running fine and you just like to update the OpenCore. It works the same way either if it's on your hard drive or if it's on a USB drive. I will just show you how to update the necessary files on the USB drive, and you can do it the same way on your hard drive if you like to. Okay, so I plugged in a USB drive that has a macOS Big Sur installer with OpenCore, and maybe you remember, and I give you the link to my
tutorials how to install that, we need the FE partition where the open core is installed to mount it to be able to access it. And we do that with the terminal, and let me just enlarge it a little bit so you can see what I'm doing here. And disk utilis, so you see which hard drives are in your device. And as I have four hard drives, there's a long list with devices, either synthesized or physical. And as I'm searching for my USB drive, you see here, disk 8 is external physical, that's the USB drive, and the FE partition here is disk 8 S1. If I would look for my system hard drive, then I would look here for the disk 0 internal physical, that is with an FE drive, that is my 480 gigabyte SSD system drive. Okay, now we use the USB. We just type sudo disk util mount and then disk 8 S1, that's the one we just found out. It needs the password and it's mounted. That was everything we need from the terminal right now. And you see here, install macOS Big Sur's USB drive, but there's another drive showed up here, it's FE. And when you go into your browser and you go to dortania.github.io, that's Dortania's website. Many of you will remember where all the guides and tutorials are for OpenCore. And you just click on builds in the top right corner, and then you can select a product. If you click on this arrow, we are looking for down here is bootloader OpenCore package. And then you can select the version, and you can go all the way down to 055. I select the newest one, it's 073. And then you have to select the commit. What is a commit? A commit is when someone from the developer made a fix or made an update and they upload their new files into this project, they do a commit, okay? Don't worry, we just take the one where it says latest in brackets. And then you see OpenCore 073, there is a debug and a release version. Normally, the release version is fine for you. If you have trouble installing macOS, for instance, you can download the debug version, but then you have to go through all the tutorials at Dortania's website about all the features the debug version has to find out where the error is. We just say download the release. And then it downloads a zip file. And when we go to downloads, just do a double click on the zip file. You just download it. And then you have the folder OpenCore 073 release. If you just go into that folder, and let me just enlarge it a little bit, the stuff we need is in the folder x64. That means 64 bits, okay? The rest is 32 bits, documents, utilities, we don't need that. And we just go into that folder, and there we see a folder FE. And the only thing we do is a right click or a control click, and we say copy. And then we go back to our FE partition we just mounted. Here it's from the USB drive, and I would suggest you try it on a USB drive first. If there is any problems with the newer version of OpenCore because it interprets some of your config plist in a different way or wrong, you might not be able to boot anymore if you just update OpenCore on your hard disk. So maybe you just do it on a USB drive, boot from the USB drive when you select FE boot, and in the Open Core menu, you select then your hard disk. And then you see if that new Open Core can boot your hard disk. If that works, you can do the same procedure with the FE partition on your hard drive. We now go to the FE partition, and there's the same FE folder. So the only thing we do is just do a right click, and we say paste item. And it says, okay, an old folder already exists and we want to not replace, because replace would mean it deletes everything, including your config plist files. We want to do merge, okay? Or the older files will be overwritten with the newer ones, and all files that existed and there is no new version for it will remain in place. So we say merge. And if you just go into the FE folder, open core, I just enlarged that a little bit more. You see still my config plist, config 5.1, 5.1 manual, and 7.1 manual, all the different config plists I have created are still in here. But the open core FE file, let me just get the info. This one is from August 20th. So it has replaced all the old files. Your files are still in place. And then we can just do a reboot, try if it works, and you have the latest version of OpenCore updated manually.